डॉक्टर निर्जया पटेल, सीनियर रेसिडेंट एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कार्डियो कैनेसेशियोलॉजी, यूएन मेहता इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कार्डियोलॉजी एंड रिसर्च सेंटर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट हिस्ट्री ऑफ कार्डियोवास्कुलर एनेस्थेशिया, हाउ इट डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम सिंस लास्ट फ्यू डिकेड्स। सो व्हाई कार्डियक एनेस्थेशिया डेवलप एंड हाउ इट इज़ डिफरेंट फ्रॉम जनरल एनेस्थेशिया। सो हार्ट सर्जरी इम्पोजिज मोस्ट चैलेंजेस फेस बाय द एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट बिकॉज इट नीड टू प्रिजर्व लाइफ व्हाइल सर्जरी इज गोइंग ऑन द हार्ट। एंड सीवियर हार्ट डिजीज लाइक कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज, सीवियर एलवी डिसफंक्शन डिजीजेज इम्पोजिज स्पेशल डिमांड्स ऑन द एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट टू नो इन डेप्थ डिटेल ऑफ द डिजीजेज दैट पजेसिज बाय जनरल एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट। सो बिकॉज कार्डियक एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट आर द पेरी ऑपरेटिव फिजिशियन, दे आर नॉट ओनली टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द एनेस्थेटिक मैनेजमेंट बट ऑल्सो ऑफ द मेडिकल एंड थ्रू पेरी ऑपरेटिव पीरियड मैनेजमेंट। एंड कार्डियक सर्जिकल एनवायरमेंट प्रेजेंट्स अनयूजुअल टेक्नोलॉजिकल डिमांड्स लाइक मैनेजमेंट ऑफ एंटी कोएगुलेशन, नॉलेज ऑफ द कार्डियक असिस्ट डिवाइसेज, पेसमेकर, इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द डेटा ऑब्टेन बाय पल्मोनरी आर्टरी कैथेटर, इकोकार्डियोग्राफी इमेजेस। सो ऑल दिस थिंग्स रिक्वायर्स एक्सपर्टाइज डिमांड इन एज पार्ट ऑफ कार्डियक एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट इन कंपेयर टू जनरल एनेस्थेशियोलॉजिस्ट एंड रिक्वायर कॉन्स्टेंट यूज रीइन्फोर्समेंट एक्सपीरियंस एंड एजुकेशन ऑब्टेन बाय कार्डियक सर्जिकल एनवायरमेंट। As we all know, since last few decades, cardiac surgeries are evolving very fast, like from on-pump to off-pump, to ECMO, to VADS, to transplant, and number of procedures are also increasing day by day. And as the population age is also increasing, which imposes more challenges to anesthesiologists because they have morbidity and mortality. So nowadays, more and more anesthesiologists are practicing cardiac anesthesia solely in active cardiac centers, changing their focus from anesthetic management of the patient to medicine management also. Surgical and medical management also. Now there are some glimpses of cardiac surgical advancement. In 1896, the year where Paget predicted that impossibility of the cardiac surgery, Rehn in Frankfurt sutured the wound on the heart. In 1938, Children's Hospital at Boston, the resident Robert Gross performed first patent ducted arteriosus ligation. In 1944, Clarence Crawford repaired a coarctation of aorta in Skolholm. In 1944, Alfred Blalock performed her first palliative surgical procedure for cyanotic congenital heart disease in Baltimore. In 1952, Gross performed the first true open heart surgery, repairing an atrial septal defect. In 1953, John Gibbon used a heart-lung machine, cardiopulmonary bypass machine, to allow closure of the atrial septal defect under direct vision. In 1967, Christian Barnard performed the first heart transplant. In 1973, surgeons stopped the beating heart with cardioplegia using cardioplegia and thereby protecting the heart using cold hyperkalemic solution into the coronary arteries. Now coming to pioneers of cardiac anesthesiology, there are so many people who invented the cardiac anesthesia till date. Merrill Harmel, he was the first anesthesiologist administered anesthesia in successful palliation of the tetralogy of Fallot performed by Alfred in 1946. Earl Weinald, in 1940, he developed principles of anesthetic management of severe coronary artery disease, which are varied till date. He introduced the use of phenylephrine to maintain the coronary artery perfusion pressure, and he also promoted the life-saving notion of maintaining tracheal intubation and ventilator support post-operatively. Nith Noon, in 1948, he was chosen as the first anesthesiologist for the procedure that launched in the era of intracardiac surgery, a mitral valve commissurotomy. He was also introduced the use of hypothermia in cardiac surgical patient and renowned for his pioneer work in cardiac arrhythmia by using lidocaine to decrease the fibrillation after cardiac surgery. Edward Lowenstein, in 1969, he discovered the use of large dose of morphine in cardiac anesthesia. Why advancement in cardiac anesthesia is required? Because with advancing surgery, it leads to development of advancement in cardiac anesthesiology. We change from open drop ether to modern anesthetics and ventilatory method via tracheal intubation, from on-pump to off-pump surgeries, and from late extubation to early extubation. Majority of cardiac anesthesia requires new technology and knowledge promoted by books, journals. The Journal of Cardiac Anesthesiology first published in 1987. did lead to development of the leaders, training programs, a sufficient cohort of practitioners. The Society of Cardiovascular Anesthesia, founded in 1978, now has 7,000 members. Now coming to advancement in monitoring, the first patient going cardiac surgery were anesthetized using just monitoring like finger on the temporal or carotid artery. Because cardiac surgeries are more complex and particularly with the use of cardiopulmonary bypass, monitoring of hemodynamics are very vital as in the part of anesthesiologist. In 1972, Kiewit and Gable described the use of the pulmonary artery catheter intra and post-operatively. The results were inconsistent, sometimes suggesting increased risk, but it was beneficial in the patient with severe heart dysfunction. So this is the figure of pulmonary artery catheter and how it is inserted. In 1980, Sumoto introduced M-mode transesophageal echocardiography. In 1982, Keheran gave description of the 2D transesophageal echocardiography. In 1987, Debrugin and colleagues reported the use of color flow Doppler by using TEE. Transesophageal echocardiography made cardiac anesthesiologist the perioperative physician who can guide the surgeon throughout the procedure. So this is the figure showing echocardiography machine and how, and the second one is image of the transesophageal echocardiography. Other methods of monitoring include central venous pressure monitoring to fluid management in cardiac vascular patients. Another is invasive blood pressure monitoring, beat to beat blood pressure monitoring, patient undergoing cardiac surgery. Now coming to drug regimen and its evolvement. Before 1969, cyclopropane, ether and halothane were exclusively used in cardiac anesthesia. But due to death during induction and inability to differentiate between cardiac from the pulmonary failure after cardiopulmonary bypass, they are very common with use of these agents. So with their advancement, in 1969, Lowenstein introduced the use of high-dose morphine for cardiac anesthesia. But two randomized controlled trials in 1973 found no advantage of morphine over halothane and ketamine. So till 1980, there was no such agent like adult cardiac anesthetics. But with increasing number of patients with severe coronary artery disease, the search for the better cardiac anesthesia technique is still there. So in 1973, Stanley reported the use of high-dose fentanyl for congenital and valvular surgeries. But the problem with this high-dose opioid anesthesia is patient awareness, because the less anesthetic agent may be given to avoid cardiac depression and high dose of opioid provide unreliable amnesia. So subsequent large and small studies revealed there is no such agent like ideal cardiac anesthetics. Optimal care for any given patient require matching of patient's pathophysiology with the pharmacology of the drug and by knowledge and skill-based clinicians. So this is a timeline of advancement in the cardiac surgery as well as cardiac anesthesia from 1940 to 200, as I already told. So significant advancement in cardiac anesthesia till date is use of the transesophageal echocardiography and intra-aortic balloon pulsation, cardiac pharmacology, management of cardiopulmonary bypass, fast-track cardiac anesthesia and recovery, advancement in the perioperative monitoring and as well as organ protection, use of antifibrinolytic drugs to prevent blood loss, specifically on patient with on-pump cardiovascular surgeries, exclusively use of pain relief in postoperative period, perioperative outcome improvement and resources utilization, that is evidence-based medicine. Thank you.